What do dogs think when you leave the house? Do they miss you? Do you ever wonder what your dog is thinking when you leave the house? Do they miss you? While we may never truly know what our canine friends are thinking, we can make educated guesses based on their behavior. In this video, we'll explore some of the common signs of missing an owner and take a look at some of the research done to understand how dogs feel when their owners are away. Number 1. Do they think you have abandoned them? Do they feel confused? Dogs can experience feelings of abandonment and confusion when their humans leave the house. As social animals, dogs rely on their pack, and when that pack suddenly disappears, it can be distressing for them. This feeling is further heightened if the dog is new to the family or hasn't yet established a routine. So next time you leave the house, remember that your furry friend might feel a little sad without you. But don't worry too much. Your dog is likely waiting eagerly for your return and will be overjoyed to see you when you come home. Number 2. Do dogs know that we are not dogs? As social animals, dogs have developed the ability to understand the differences between themselves and other creatures. Dogs have a mental category for humans, which means that they can tell if they are interacting with another dog or a human. This is evident in the way they behave differently when interacting with humans compared to other dogs. They may wag their tails more when they see a human or sit calmly, which they may not do when interacting with other dogs. Furthermore, dogs are also able to differentiate between dogs and non-dogs visually. A study conducted by researchers at the University of Paris found that dogs were able to separate the images of dogs from non-dogs. This suggests that dogs are able to recognize physical differences between themselves and other animals. So even though dogs might view us as being in a different mental category from themselves, this doesn't stop them from forming deep bonds with us. In fact, they are known to be highly social animals that thrive on social interaction and companionship. Number 3. What do dogs think about all day? However, just because dogs may not actively think about things in the same way humans do, it doesn't mean they're just mindlessly staring off into space. Dogs are very much creatures of habit and routine. So they may spend their days thinking about when they'll get their next meal, when they'll get to go for a walk, or when their human will come home. Dogs also have a heightened sense of awareness, which means they're constantly scanning their surroundings and paying attention to changes in their environment. They may be watching the squirrels in the trees outside, listening to the sounds of cars driving by, or sniffing the air to pick up new scents. Another thing that dogs think about is their social relationships. Dogs are highly social animals, and they're very attuned to the social hierarchy in their packs. They may spend time thinking about how to best interact with their human family members or other dogs they encounter. Overall, while dogs may not have conscious thoughts or ideas in the way we do, they still have plenty to occupy their minds. They have their basic needs and instincts to attend to, as well as their social relationships and the environment around them to consider. Number 4. Do dogs know how long you've been gone? Studies have been conducted on whether dogs can judge how long their owners have been gone, and if they miss their humans more intensely with time. It's a question many dog owners may wonder about. Does your dog know that you have been gone for 30 minutes or several hours? One experiment in 2011 conducted by Swedish researchers placed cameras that recorded how dogs reacted when their humans were away for half an hour, 2 hours, and 4 hours. The researchers observed the dog's behavior during their owner's absence, and then recorded their reaction when their human returned. The experiment showed that dogs greeted their owners with greater excitement when their humans left them alone for 2 hours as opposed to just half an hour, which suggests that dogs can, indeed, tell the difference between these times. This means that dogs have some sense of how much time has passed. However, dogs did not react differently when their humans were gone for 2 hours versus 4 hours. The researchers noted that dogs might have trouble comprehending longer time frames, especially if they have not been trained or taught to understand them. This is likely why dogs do not seem to have a sense of how long their owners have been gone for. So while dogs may be able to differentiate between a shorter and a longer time span, they may not have the same understanding of time as we do. Dogs' sense of time is likely based on familiar patterns or events, such as meal times or walk times. What this tells us is that dogs feel time differently to us. Number 5. Do dogs really miss us when we are gone? As pet owners, one of the things that we worry about the most is whether or not our furry friends miss us when we're not around. It's hard to leave your dog behind when you go to work or run errands, but have you ever wondered if your dog actually misses you while you're gone? Recent studies have shown that dogs do, in fact, miss their owners when they're away. One study, published in the Journal of Neuroscience, looked at the brains of dogs to see how they reacted to different scents. The researchers gave the dogs five scents: the scent of a familiar and strange human, the scent of a familiar and strange dog, and the dog's own scent. Interestingly, when the dogs smelt the scent of a familiar human, the caudate nucleus of their brains lit up a region associated with positive expectations and rewards. This suggests that dogs have a positive response to their owner's scent, and they associate it with positive experiences. Another study, published in Behavioral Processes, looked at how dogs' behavior changed around people with different levels of familiarity. In one of the experiments, scientists put dogs in an unfamiliar room with three human participants: their owner, a familiar person, and a stranger. When the human participants left the room, scientists observed that the dogs would wait behind a door that their owner went through, and not the other humans. This suggests that dogs have a stronger attachment to their owners than to other people, and that they may be more likely to miss them when they're gone. While research is ongoing, combining the knowledge of dogs loving their humans and the studies we have leads to the belief that dogs do in fact miss us when we're gone. Number 6. What do dogs think about when they stare? Have you ever caught your furry friend staring at you with their big, soulful eyes? You might have wondered what exactly is going through their mind. The truth is, it all depends on what they are staring at. If your dog is staring at another dog, they might not be deep in thought. In this case, they are most likely asserting their dominance over the other dog. It's important to remember that dogs have their own unique ways of communicating with each other, and staring is just one of them. However, if your dog is staring at you, it's a completely different story. More often than not, dogs watch us to understand what we're doing. They're trying to figure out how they fit into our daily routines and how they can be helpful to us. When they stare at you, it could also be a sign of love and affection. Number 7. Do dogs get bored? As social creatures, dogs crave attention and mental stimulation. Without it, they can become restless, anxious, and even destructive. This is why it is important to provide your dog with plenty of playtime and activities to keep them mentally and physically engaged. Some signs that your dog may be bored include excessive barking, chewing on objects they are not supposed to, digging, or just generally being uninterested in anything going on around them. If you notice these behaviors, it may be time to shake up your dog's routine and find new ways to keep them entertained. So that's all for it for today. I hope you all like this video. Please let us know in the comment box about your opinion, and do recommend some topics you want to see in the video in the future.